Good afternoon, students. Now I am going to show you how to do question number 46 in GIT online exam. Now, if you are coming here for the first time, you can go on top right corner. You can see how to create a user account, and then thereafter you can see the first login, how to log in to this site. And then once you log in, you have to download the source file folder, the zip folder, for these structured questions. So you can get all the details from there. And with the question number 41 and 42 also, I have explained how to download the this source file folder and how to unzip and how to do the things. Now today I am directly going to this web development techniques, the question number 46. Here mainly you will be evaluated for HTML. Now we'll consider about the question. It says, consider the web page given in figure 1. This web page has to be created using the HTML file and the picture.png file in the Q46 folder. Now as you can see, the source file, it contains seven folders for each and every question, from question 41 to 47. So inside those folders, sometimes you get the source file, or sometimes you are not getting any file there. But you have to say what you are doing inside those folders. So sometimes you have the source files, so you have to use that and create the file. Do the modification, then you have to save it back with the question name, and then from there you have to upload the file to the examination department through this paper, through this page. Now we'll just go and see how this Q46 folder. Now you can see I have downloaded it onto my desktop. So when you go for the original exam also, you have to do something like this. So I just go inside, the source file is there, and the four, yes, I just double click twice, that's why. You can see there are seven folders there. Now I'm going inside to Q46. Now here you can see picture and source file is there. We'll go to the instructions again. Now it says now there's a figure actually. Then we'll go down. It says figure 1, desired web page. Then first one, it says, first part, the HTML source code has 12 missing HTML tags or terms indicated by labels numbered as 1 to 12 as shown in figure 2. In figure 2, you can see there are numbers from 1 to 12. They have numbered 1 to 12, some blank spaces where are the tags you have to put. Then select the suitable tags terms for the labels from the list given below and write them in the HTML source code in order to get the required web page. Now here you can see they have given a list of tags. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to select the correct tag from here and put it here to the spaces, to the numbered spaces where there are missing tags are there. You have to put the relevant tag from this list. You have to just go through this and you have to put the relevant tag, and once you put the tags there, the output should be like this. Okay, the final output, the desired web page is this. So we'll go back to the question again. It says, the second one, test your source code using a web browser. Now you should know, when you are doing HTML, when you do it, you have to test it with the web browser. Okay, then only you can see all the things are coming, the changes you have done will come. Okay, this is actually a tag sort of instruction file here. So according to that, web browser will manipulate, the web browser will show the output according to these instructions. Okay, so this is a sort of message to the web browser which says, okay, this you have to do, this you have to do. Like this, the font should be bolded. Like this, the font should be underlined. The header file, these font should comes as a header. So like this, those instruction will be given by the tags. Okay, we'll go to the last one. I just want to go to the last. Save your HTML file in the Q46 folder with the file name Q46 and upload it. Okay, So I'm just going back to the folder. Here you can see this is an HTML file. So we have to change this. Okay, we have to modify this. We have to fill the blanks, the numbered spaces. We have to fill with the correct tags. So then we have to save this as question 46. So before going to do this, what I'm doing, I'll just right click on it and take copy of this, and again I'll select a blank space, right click on it and say paste. So now you can see source copy is there. I'm just right clicking on it and say rename, and then I'm putting Q46 here. So once you go there, if you just double click, this will open as a web page. Okay, this will open as a web page like this. So here we can see the output, which they have mentioned that you have to go to a web browser and see the output like that. So you can see it from here. But if you want to edit this, you can't use this HTML file. You can't do it by opening it as an HTML file. So this is how it comes, the HTML file. See, you can see the tags are not correct because of that. This is how the file is coming. They are not interpreted because the web browser can't understand because the relevant tags are not there. So I'm going back to the folder. Here what you have to do, keep this in mind, what you have to do if you want to edit this, you have to open it with the notepad. To do that, you have to right click on this and then you have to go to open with, and from there you can select the notepad. So once you open with the notepad, there you can, it's a text editor, there you can change these parts, and then you have to say file save, and then you can refresh here and you will get the output. So one by one we'll see how we can do this. Okay, I'm going back to the question paper. Now you can see on my web browser there are two tabs. One is the question paper, the other one is the page which we have we are creating, okay, which we are modifying, the Q46. So here I'm going back to the question paper. Here you can see we'll see this here you can see we'll go through this. Actually this is easy. From here, from this file, this figure 2, try to find what is 1, what is 2, what is 3, because if you go to the notepad, you can see there's nothing, no coloring, no highlighting. You can't do it in notepad, right? But here you can see 1 is there, 2 is there, 3 is there, they are not highlighted. So don't use this notepad to see what's inside, what should happen like that. Use this figure 2. It's easy for you. That's why I'm telling. Okay. Now here you can see 1. It says center, then drug abuse information in Sri Lanka. Then again center, then again 1. So which means this part, the drug abuse information in Sri Lanka, this part will be centered with these two tags, and something else is there. We'll go to the output and see. Okay, now you can see drug abuse information Sri Lanka is centered, that was there, and you can see it's highlighted and the font size it's bold and the font size is bigger like that. So this can be done with the header, okay, header tag, we call it header tag. So if you just go through this, you can see there are two header tags, H1 and then H3, okay, but we have to go for H1 because this is a little big, not little big, this is a big one. See, you can see it's a H1, you can select, okay. So what you can do, there are two things you can do. You will get a rough paper, so you can write down on the rough paper, okay, 1 is this, 2 is this, 3 is this, like that. You can just interpret this, you can just go through this and find what is 1 to 12, and at once you can go to this notepad and change those things and save and run it. Or else you can go one by one. Okay, here I am going to do it with one by one. Okay, now here we found that this is H1. 1 is H1. So I have to go to this place and I'm going to change this 1. You have to delete the parentheses also. Okay, otherwise it's not coming properly. Here I have to type H1. Now you may remember these tags are not case sensitive, which means you can type it in capital or you can type it in simple, or you can use mix of capital and simple. Okay, now here I put H1 here. What I can do, what I have to do, go to file, press save button. This will save it inside that HTML file. Then we can go to this HTML file and refresh it. By pressing this refresh button, it will send the request again. So it will take the page again. Now page will be open from that file which we have saved through Notepad. So it's taking some time. We'll see. Yeah, you can see now it has been bold and it has been a bigger size. It changed to a bigger size, the font, and that is H1. Definitely that is H1. Okay, you can just compare it if you are not sure. See, it's H1. Then we can go to the next one. It says 2, then 3, src picture.png, alter, say no to drugs, then 150, and then height 100. Now definitely this 4 should be width, and this is an image. No, src picture.png means image. Or even you, when you just go through this, you can see there's a picture next to that heading. So here, when you put a picture, you have to say img. 3 should be img, and src means that is source, right? So you should know for some tags there are attributes. So here img tag, definitely there should be an attribute. Other than that, just the image img tag is useless. Okay, now here this should be img and there's no closing tag, and this 2 should be center. You have seen the image is centered, so this 2 should be center, and then 4 should be width. So I'm going to change those things here. You can just go through the list also. Center is there, img is there, width is there, so you can get the correct spellings also. You have to type correctly. Now here 2 is center. I'm going to change it, and this should be center, center, not British English, centre, because here we are using American English, so you have to write it center. Now I'm going to the next 2 tag. So like that, you have to, if there's open and close tag both, then first change both and then go to the next number. Okay, you have to keep that in mind. Okay, now center, then I'm going to number 3, that is img. I can type img. Then the 4th tag with parenthesis I have to remove, width. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I have to go to file, save, then I have to come back to this web page and press the refresh button, reload this page. Okay, now we'll see what will happen. Now here you can see 2, 3 was there. Now what will come, we'll see. Still coming. Here the image, earlier there was no image, only the font is there. Now you can see the image and it has been centered. Okay, Now we'll go to the next one. It says number 5, okay. Over 250,000 youth. Now we'll go to the desired page and see. See, you can see it's bold. Now this is a little bit dark, more darker than the rest. So that is bold. So here fifth one should be B. You can see B is there, okay. So I'm going back. I'm going to change this fifth one to B. Okay, B, and then here B. Now I'm not going to save this again and go back to that place. I'm going to do several things and do it at once. Now the next one we'll go to sixth. B, six, several type of illegal drugs, and then six again. We'll go and see bolded, something should be there. Here you can see several types of illegal drugs. It's been bolded, and again it has been underlined. So here we will see, you can see U is there. See, U is there, which means underline. So this should be, the 6 should be underlined. I'm going there and change 6 to U, underline. Okay, then we'll go to the 7th one. 7th one, it says now here LI, when you see LI, you may remember, okay, this is a list. It might be a ordered list or unordered list. If there's 1, 2, 3, that is ordered. If there's the bullets, then that is unordered. Here there are bullets, so which means those are unordered. There's no particular order. So you can see UL is there, so unordered list. So we have to put here for the 7 UL. 2 sevens are there. You have to be careful with that. Whenever you see a number, you have to check whether there's another closing tag for that particular number. Then you have to change both. Okay. Now here I am putting UL. Now I'm going to save this and see what will happen. Now I am going to just save it and go to this and refreshed. We'll see what is happening. Okay. Now here you can see that is 250,000 youth, and then this underline has come, and then the unordered list has been okay. Now then next one you can see 8, 9 is not, 10 is not yet corrected, and 11, 12 is not yet corrected, and these bullets are there. But if you go to this one, it says those should be numbered list, okay, and there are some more changes. Now we'll go to the next one. It is number 8. You can see drug addiction statistics, both 8 and 9 is there. We'll just go and see what's there. Here you can see it's bolded, italic text or fonts. So here 8 and 9 should be bold and italic. Those two can be changed, doesn't matter. Okay, now here you can see I is there, B is there, so it's bold and italic. So I'm going back to this notepad and I'm going to change 9, 8 as bold, B, and again here 8 I have to change as B, then 9 should be italic. This could be changed, okay, it can be italic, 9 could be bold, doesn't matter. Then we'll go to the next one and I'm going to see what is next. The 10th, you can see again it's a list, and if you can remember, it's a ordered list. So ordered list means OL, so I have to put OL here. Then if you go to this, you can see heroin, then there's 11 and 12 blue, okay. Now this is font color. Font color should be blue. Font color red. 11 and 12 should be font and color. Now why I am telling this? I just went here. You can see this is font, the color has been changed to blue. This color has been changed to red. So here that's it. They have given here the font color blue and then font color red. So here we going back here. Now you have to say 10th will be ordered list, OL. Again the closing tag, OL. Then here this should be font, and if you just remember, this is not the way how they have given you the, here you can see it's been 11 and 12, there's nothing in between. Okay, so like here also it should be like that. Okay, font is the tag and the attribute is color. Now you can see here also this open and close, these two one should not be there. There should be a space, that should not be. This is how it's in the question paper even. See, so you have to change it, you have to be very careful. Now you can see this is a very easy task, you have to find it and put it here. So sometimes there might be some errors, or purposely they might have put it there to evaluate you well. Okay, whether you can do whether you have understood the basics. So they will put it like this. Okay, font, and here should be color. Again you have to remember, color should be COLOR, not UR. Why? This is American English. Okay, so font color. So I'm going to copy this and paste it here, because this is the same thing. Now here this closing tag should not be there, that is also wrong. Okay, so sometimes they might have given it for evaluation purpose, whether you know the exact tags, how to do the tags or not. Okay, now here I'm going to file and press save, and what I have to do, I have to go and reload the page. Now you can see it's opening. Loading. Still loading. Okay, now it has come, but marijuana is also blue. We'll go to this and see if it is there. No. Then what has happened here, you can see this tag, they, even though they have opened the font tag, they have not closed it here. So what will happen, this font comes with this color, they have not, now the 50,000 has been colored, but they have not closed, there's no close tag. Okay, that's why this is coming like this. So if you want, if you can remember, you can put a closing tag here like this. Font, the attributes, there are so many attributes, but actually we have open font tag. Okay, so you have to close it. Only this part is okay, next part there's no nothing afterwards, no, so you don't have to close that. We will say file, save and reload again. It's better you can you can close the next font tag even. Okay, I'm going to copy this and paste it here, so you will be close. Okay, even though there's nothing afterward, it's good practice, you can close it. Yeah, okay, now you can see the output, it's okay. Okay, once you have done, now the notepad you can save and close it. Then this also you can close, because you have already done, it's okay, corrected. And then what you have to do, you have to go and upload it. Otherwise, even though you have done it, the paper examination department won't see it. So here you have to go down and click on this button, and then you will get this window, and you will be open with upload a file, or if it is not, you have to click on it, and then you will get this window. You have to go to choose file, and then you have to choose the file. So here I have saved it on desktop, mock exam, jitmock exam. Inside that the source file is there, and inside Q46 we have saved it as Q46. You have to select that and then say upload this file. It will be uploaded like this. Okay, now if you are doing exactly this part only, you can just go and say finished attempt. Or if you want to finish off the exam, you can go to other question papers. If you know some more things, you can go to other question papers and do it, and then finished attempt. Now how to finish this attempt and afterward what will happen is also I have given in the first login video. See, I have put it here again. The series, there's a playlist of JITMOK exam videos, so I have put it on. If you just look above, you can see on right top corner they are giving the video links. And another thing is, now this is the mock exam papers, and I have some examples which may come this year. Okay, we have targeted and we have created some questions. They might have come within the next exam. So if you are interested, you can gain those by subscribing to our channel, and you can click on the bell icon even. Then you will get, as soon as we uploaded those videos and the exercises, you will get the alert message. And by subscribing, you will get those things into your email also. Okay, have a good day.